Sensorineural hearing loss is a term which is wrongly used. Most of the people get misled by the term that a sensorineural hearing loss is equal to a neural hearing loss. Okay, first you have to understand the pathway of sound entering inside the ear and into the nerve and to the brain. So, for example, most of the people think that it's a nerve problem. Doctor said, I'm having a nerve issue. I'm not hearing because of my nerve issue, etc. In case it is a nerve issue, imagine the nerve and the wire are one and the same. What is that? A nerve and wire are one and the same. In case I'm putting a current over the one end of the wire, the second end of the wire will get the delivery of the current. If I cut the wire into two halves, naturally, the first end, if I put a current, will it come to the second end of the second wire? No. So, in case it is a nerve issue, even a thunder sound, one can't able to sense. Most of us are thinking that tinnitus, I'm having a ringing sound and it is due to a nerve. In case it is a nerve issue, how can you able to hear that tinnitus sound? So, that is not an acceptable answer for the query. Okay, so sensorineural hearing loss is nothing but any disturbance to the sound path from the stapes bone, end of the stapes bone to the auditory part of the brain. If a sound disturbance happens, perception of sound happens to be having a difficulty, that is called a sensorineural hearing loss. We people are wrongly misguided and wrongly misunderstood the concept of sensorineural hearing loss. First, let me start from the top. In case there is a problem in the auditory cortex of the brain, even a person can't able to sense the thunder sound or a bomb blast sound. In case I'm coming down from the auditory cortex, in case there is a problem in the nerve conductivity, nerve has no work. Okay, nerve is a wire, its duty is to conduct. Okay, I am putting a current, in case it is reflected on the other end, it means nerve is working. So, in case a nerve issue, nerve has only two problems as far as hearing is concerned. One is compression or stopping of signal to the nerve. Second is the nerve cut. In case a nerve cut, even a thunder sound or bomb blast sound, one can't able to hear. The nerve has two types of issues. The first is called auditory dyssynchrony. Auditory dyssynchrony can be compared to, imagine I'm plugging a mic to the device and I'm talking. So, the moment the circuit is inside, my voice can be amplified by the mic. So, what happens when the plugging of mic has been unplugged? I may talk, but no sound amplification is done because there is no current circulation inside. Likewise, in an auditory dyssynchrony condition, a patient can able to sense even, for example, they can even sense the clock ticking sound. All of a sudden, what they have happens, they can't even sense the bomb blast sound after some time. There will be a circuit inside, that circuit has a regular flow of current. What happens, it has been intermediately stopped, that is called auditory dyssynchrony, the nerve issue. What happens, we people wrongly thinking that actually the sensorineural hearing loss is the major hearing loss, which has been a major type in the hearing loss segment actually. We have been wrongly thought that it is a nerve issue and we go for a neurologist, ask, he will be giving some vitamin tablets, mineral tablets, food supplements, wagera. You have to understand about the condition. How come a vitamins or mineral food supplements is going to help you? Don't cheat yourself actually. First, understand the scientific approach towards regaining hearing condition has to be there. Without going into the scientific aspects, scientific approach, it isn't going to help us. Our first aim is to protect our existing hearing capacity and then to increase the hearing capacity. What we do, we are in an urge world actually. We used to, my father has to hear, my mother has to hear, my wife has to hear. Out of this curiosity, what we do, we just go there and put a hearing aid. That is not that much worth, whether you spend a 300 or 30 lakh rupee hearing aid. It is not worth actually. Because a natural hearing is not equal to any form of hearing actually. So try to understand about the present condition and treat for the root cause of the condition rather than going for an amplification device. So we people have been thinking that, no sir, now the science is more advanced and we have lots and lots of devices. We have mobile phones, laptops, etc. And we have biggest RAMs. And if we are the people who thinking that these are the biggest devices, most advanced devices, actually that is the height of stupidity. The most advanced machine is this, the human body. Try to understand about the condition. Our body is well-equipped machine. I don't think any phone is a very advanced, isn't it? So we keep upgrading our science. That's what the science, whatever the science we talk today, this is a science that will be upgraded, and whatever the science devices which we have now will be totally vanished after some time. That is the science. So the thing is, we have to keep upgrading our level of understanding. So these type of videos has been given just to enlighten the people who are in need. The sensorineural hearing loss is not a neural hearing loss. In case there is a neural problem, even a thunder sound one can't able to hear, and the other condition I said, the auditory dyssynchrony condition. So what is the problem actually, where it lies? We have to think. So just see, I have a paper here. Okay, so I'm blowing the air. It's moving. Is it moving? No. So can we say that I haven't kept the paper there? It is not moving to my blow, nah? So can we say that there is no paper? The thing is, the air which I blow is been blocked by the hand here. So the paper is not moving. Okay. So this is the same condition which naturally we tends to come across in the hearing loss segment is concerned, particularly in case of the sensorineural hearing loss. What happens is, the sound conducted into the cochlear is not converted properly as a sound signal to the nerve. So we saying it is a nerve issue. We are not understanding the condition. The sound conducted into the cochlear is not properly converted into signal and sent into the nerve. So that is an issue. So what we are doing, why this problem arises, it is due to the pressure inside the cochlear. So what we people do, okay, you already having the pressure. So you put a lot of pressure by using a hearing aid. You have to hear, na? So put a hearing aid. Okay. By putting hearing aid, what happens when all the sounds come from near will be having a lot of pressure. I have already explained. So what happens? Instead of lesser pressure, we are increasing much pressure to the cochlear than what it can bear. And it will gradually reduce your hearing capacity.